just that as I listened to all the previous committee meetings, including when I was on the committee, and it really has been our intention right from the start to try to get this right, to do it slowly and carefully in consultation, and also to show that we're doing it stage by stage and listen to you and get your feedback. And in terms of the cemeteries rule, if we have people at the moment seeing signs and knowing that the law is that you can't take your dog into a cemetery, then most law-abiding people are going to follow that law, even though they might want to take their dog in to see a loved one. They're going to follow the law, so it's really important that we get it clear and get it right. And if we don't mind people going into cemeteries, then we should have a law that says that. It's not for our residents that only those people who are prepared to break rules can get to do something. So we want to make it clear, we want to make it precise, get everybody to know exactly what they can and can't do in each area, make that clear, make it acceptable, make everybody understand, and work with residents so that we do get it right. And obviously that's why we keep coming back to scrutiny. We're not going to do anything without bringing it to scrutiny. We're not going to suddenly impose massive extra bits of PSPL without bringing it to scrutiny. So pretty much guaranteed that we're not going to do anything behind anybody's back. We value your feedback, and that's why we've taken it away and acted on it. At first, we accepted the feedback that said you can't do this PSPO, you have to stick with the bylaws. And then we had legal advice that we absolutely couldn't do that, and that's why we're here at this point with a second round of attempts to get it right and to stick to the law. And we're trying to help residents. We don't want people not able to go to cemeteries with their dogs to visit the graves of loved ones because they're law-abiding citizens. That's just wrong. That's not fair. And those people who are prepared to break the rules, they can do what they like. That's really not fair. The next stage could well be, if people want that from this committee, that we look at dog fouling, then we look at dog fouling. And we're happy to consult openly on that as well. I don't see that Mike has said anything controversial or wrong. And we have listened to committee after committee to this to try and get it right. Really want to get this right. Thank you.
I've got Steve and Leslie.
Yeah, I just want to clarify that I agree with everything Christine says. I mean, I'm not against enforcement in any way or anything like this. I do see this just the first step. I'm just getting the groundwork in, so we've at least got the place right, and then we answer it later, which is why I don't think we should reject what we've put so far. I fully expect more to come, and hopefully we'll get more robust sort of methods in to prevent dog fouling and whatever else we think needs to be conscious.
So I'm
going to
be I really do need persuading that by putting signs up, this is going to solve all the problems. I mean, we put signs up, no ball games, and it's unenforceable. We know that when we push it in, and residents are plagued with, you know, all sorts of people knocking balls up against particular side walls, and we have a nice sign there. And when you say to somebody, you know, there's a no ball games here, they just tell you to go away. It's a complete nonsense, really. All I can read out of this report is tonight to say that we're going to put some signs up in the cemeteries and the play areas and the muggers, and that's going to stop people. Sorry, I think it would delude us if we think that this is going to. And I know that you say, you know, we're trying to do things and we're trying to do it in pieces. I think that really is, it might take longer, but it's the wrong way to do it, and we should be looking at the whole policy of dog fouling across the whole of the spectrum of Wirral. And, you know, let's face it, if we're going to do it, then we have to put some money behind this. And if ever there was a time to be looking at putting some money into the budget for next year, otherwise we're going to be in the same position as we are this time next year, where we won't have any enforcement at all. And laugh at us. I mean, if we want to take, for instance, you know, the caravans and the motorhomes that were parking down in my ward. I know it's a completely different issue, but if we just put signs up there and said, no, you can't do it, they'd have just laughed at us and told us where to go again. But, you know, we have to have, quite rightly, because it comes
where we have some enforcement policies behind us. Otherwise, we're tinkering around the edges, we're doing a bit here, we're doing a bit there, and we're not addressing the problem. And how long has this gone on? This must be, what, 2 years, is it now? At least 2 years. So, you know, I think we've got to, as I say, you know, try and bring this back as quickly as possible with a more composite report. Let's look at the enforcement policy. I've advocated some years ago, I think when I was the cabinet member, a long, long time, it must be 10 years ago, for that we should be able to actually fine people for a start if they're allowing their dogs to foul and they're not picking up after themselves, and publicise their names on, you know, the front of the likes of the Wirral Globe. And the answer I got to that was, well, these people, they've got their, you know, they have human rights, and I'm all for people having their human rights, so it wouldn't be right to put people's names on the front of newspapers. The whole thing is a nonsense. It's a nonsense. And we've got to get to grips with it properly, and we've got to do it in one attempt where we can do it completely across the whole borough.
Okay, I know I'm going to come back in a minute, if that's okay. What I'm going to do is just take the rest of the committee and then if you want to come back, I don't normally do that, but since we've allowed it, why not? So we've got Tony, is there anybody else that wants to come in?
Thank you, Chair. I can't really disagree with what everybody's saying. The silence is not going to start happening, but it's a start. I think this has been such a contentious issue. Have Kingdom trying to enforce, and that went down like a lead balloon, how many people were here. But it's a start that we, you know, right back to the beginning, strictly back to the bone. The issue has not gone away. Kingdom has, happily, but the dog farm is still here, and we need to start, and we need to start sensibly, one force in front of the other. If we come heavy handed, I understand we need the urgency for it, but if we come up with another idea that, again, does go down on the bully, what do we do? You know, we're right back to square one. We do need enforcement, absolutely. You know, I own three dogs. I can't even talk to a civilist, but, you know, how many times I've walked through an entry to take my dogs to the woods, and it's just strewn with dog waste. Something has to be done, but, you know, there's a sign that still says, an old one saying, the fines will be. It's not between, but with all the ferocity that was caused by Kingdom and the enforcement, if it's Kingdom, if it's council officers, when someone gets fined, they're not going to be happy. And there was an element of the backlash about people being fined. I understand it was heavy handed by Kingdom, but we need to get everybody on board, have a sensible solution. And it's great to hear there's no grandstanding going on for the change. You know, we have not done it, as we've heard, we can't throw money at this. It needs to be some kind of, you know, funded by the fines. But let's just do it one step at a time. And I can't disagree with the recommendations. Yes, I think we could have to have national enforcement or some ideas about enforcement and how we can go about it. But we've got to start somewhere and we've got to be sensible. You know, it's a contentious issue. If we go at it like a bullet again, so to speak, we're just going to have a backlash again. So that's all I want to say.
Okay, anybody else?
In response to the criticisms about the signage, I think first of all it was this committee that suggested or ordered us to go away and abandon our contract with Kingdom, and that was then done a mutual agreement. So this committee didn't want Kingdom, this committee didn't want the zero tolerance approach. And so I appreciate and we hear that this committee would like a more robust method for the signage. So we'll take that away, we'll think about it. However, I think it is really disingenuous to our residents to suggest that signage just won't work. That our residents, who are almost all of them really good law-abiding people, will just ignore signs. I think that's pretty outrageous. If I were listening to some of the members of this committee suggesting that signs won't work because all our residents just ignore them and tell them to wipe off, I think that I'd be really insulted by that. So I actually think signage will work because Wirral residents are, on the whole, law-abiding citizens. They do follow signage, but in a number of places, as has been pointed out numerous times in this meeting, in a number of places, we don't have signs up. And the reasons we don't have signs up at the moment is because there are no laws covering those places. Places have been created since the bylaws were put in place, and therefore the bylaws don't cover them. So we need, and this government has recommended that we need a PSPM to cover those areas. Signage will be enough for most people, because most people are aware of good law-abiding citizens, and it is very insulting to suggest otherwise. However, this meeting is not about anything other, and this meeting, I will wrap up, this meeting is not about fouling, and most of the time people have been talking about fouling. We agree fouling is a big problem, and we do want to address it, but the proposals put forward tonight are about cemeteries and play areas and kickbacks. It's not about fouling, that is for another meeting, and we're really ready to consult and listen to feedback on your ideas about fouling. What we'd like is your response and your recommendations about cemeteries and play areas and kickbacks. That's what we'd really like for this meeting. Thank you.
Thank you, Chip. This is not going to be back and forth. I'm going to be a Parliament member, so thank you, Liz, if that's okay. Just to defend this committee, there was a robust response over Kington, but that was attacking people, dropping litter robustly on cigarette butts, sometimes falsely. It wasn't against dog fouling. Well, speaking for myself, I've got no problem with that robust endorsement on dog fouling. And people don't read the signs because they walked up to the sideways day to day, as I was along the beach, it's supposed to be dog. So obviously some rural residents aren't law abiding. I'm going to take three more. Andy?
I'm sorry you felt outraged for what I said, because I was only being factual. I agree that signage should be put up, but we can't rely on it to stop what's happening. It's not the majority who've got to worry about the law abiding people, it's the small amount. And I gave you examples, walking around a park hospital, there's people smoking all over the place, there's signs everywhere, they just don't pay any attention. And Christina, if you go down the Wirral Way, I'm sure as the cabinet member you do go around the Wirral, if you go down the Wirral Way, you are told to F off. If you say to someone there's a sign there, they tell them to go and do one. And I'm only speaking from experience of what happens. You can't rely entirely on signage to stop people letting their dogs foul. I'm sorry if you felt outraged, because I live in the real world.
I think it's getting heated now, but I think basically we all agree over what we want done. It's what's concerning us is how we enforce it, and what's the point in putting signs up if we've got no way of enforcing it. So I would have thought a way forward would be if we could agree that this is one step along the way, but it's not to be enforced yet, and when the full report comes back to us, we've agreed this small part of it, so long as it fits in with the other part of it, because we can't keep agreeing this in piecemeal. And whilst we were all of the opinion that we could do the cemeteries and the play areas quite quickly, I think we all felt we were going to get the full package back. I don't think we felt we were going to get bits here and there. And I think that's what we're saying. And whilst none of us are saying that everybody in the Wirral is not law-abiding, by the admission of Wirral Council, 2% of the population, this dog mug, aren't law-abiding. And their dog doesn't go to the toilet once in a lifetime. It probably goes twice a day. So that's what we're looking at, 2%, 2 poos a day. And as for the Wirral Way, yes, you get lots and lots of cyclists who are really, really good. But then you get the 2% or 3% of cyclists who aren't very good. And they go on the horse track, they go on the shared track, and they don't take the rule that pedestrians come first. So what we're saying is based on our experience of that 1 or 2%. And it's that 1 or 2% that get reported to us as councillors. And that's why we're mentioning it. And I don't think we can sit here and not defend the fact that we didn't demand X, Y, and Z over Kingham. We brought the views of our residents and our views as councillors over Kingham. And I think we did a very good job in what we did in the scrutiny of that whole business. So I don't think we should be criticised or anything else over that. I just feel now if we could agree these 2 points as the starting points, not to be enforced just yet, and then we can quickly get the next part. Otherwise, we'll be here for for the next 10 years getting bits of this, and half of us will be dead and forgotten what the first two parts were. So, really, going on now, though, yes, remind me, when you find out what some of us now know about Wirral. I don't think anybody is objecting in principle to what's going on. We are just concerned about the way the whole thing is now running out.
Okay, thank you. Right. Lesley,
I'm not going to talk at all.
Clearly,
do take this as an insult to say that, you know, we're choosing the people of Wirral as if, you know, they're all. The report, I just won't go into it because we're just getting to a slanging match, which is not what we need to do. So if we can put signs up, as we do